channel. Hi guys, my name is Trishna and I make videos on beauty, lifestyle, travel. Basically, I try and incorporate everything on my channel. And today's story is really close to my heart and it talks about the roots of my country. So without doing a lot of talking, let's get on the video and see what is today's mysterious story. So first things first, I have already applied a primer today, and today the primer that I have used is this one. This is NYX Photo Loving Primer. This is very good. If you have a oily skin, it will control a lot of oil. I've done that and I'm gonna directly jump into my concealer, and today's concealer is this one. This is Revlon Colorstay Concealer. This is the one concealer that I use for almost every video of mine, and I'm in the shade medium. So yes, so today's story is, as I mentioned, really special to me. So today I'm gonna talk about this beautiful city of India, which is also known as the submerged city of India. It's called Dwarka. Dwarka is also known as Devbhumi. The reason being because in the last few years of Lord Krishna's life, he spent most of his time in Dwarka. So now that my eyes are concealed, I'm going to go directly into my eyes, and today I'm using this particular palette. This is called Sweet Sunday. These are the colors I'm playing around today with. So Dwarka is believed to have been one of the first capitals of Gujarat, because it is the magical land where Lord Krishna had his empire. I can't even call it an empire, it was just like palaces all over the place. But one fine day, everything vanished underwater, and hence it is called the submerged city of Dwarka. Now when I say submerged, is basically the whole of the Dwarka city, the Dwarka's palaces, the kingdoms which were there back then, which is approximately like 10,000 years ago, is completely inside water. So when we talk about history and kingdoms and, you know, palaces and stuff like that, the archaeologists are very much interested. So if I talk about the history of Dwarka, Dwarka was built around 10,000 years ago. So the archaeologists believe that the civilization in India dated back around 3,000 to 6,000 years ago. But when they see Dwarka, it dates back around 9,000 to 10,000 years ago, which is so mind-boggling, to be very honest. And they know this because they actually found the sunken kingdom inside the water. If I talk from the point of view of an archaeologist, this particular city is like a treasure to them. So a lot of remains of the sunken kingdom has been found in the city of Dwarka, which also proves that the civilization existed 10,000 years ago. So I have done like 50% of my eyes. I want to do it once I finish my face. So I'm going to go in with my foundation, and this is Fix and Click Foundation F3 Sand from Seri, and this is how it looks like. The city back then had 9 lakh plus palaces all over, and they were made from silver and embedded with emeralds. I mean, like, imagine how rich the empire is. And in today's times, the experts consider that particular royal empire as one of the finest architectural designs that was created, because they have a blueprint of it, and when they look at the construction of the whole palace, it is so beyond time that you can't even imagine, like, the way it is constructed and the way the vision of that particular palace was. And they consider it as unlike any construction they have seen so far. And this is, I'm talking about like 10,000 years ago. But the interest started only after the marine archaeologists started taking little interest, and, you know, they were like really excited to explore this submerged city. So the excavations started in the year 1988, and to their surprise, they found a lot of potteries and handicrafts which hailed around the time of Indus Valley civilization. But the turning point came in when the students from Gulf of Cambay accidentally found a lot of things. So I'm almost done with my face. I'm gonna go in with Seri Cosmetics. This is the gold pencil that I have been using off lately. So what exactly did the Gulf of Cambay students found? They found sandstone walls, they found copper coins, they found a lot of other artifacts. And all these were dated back to 9,500 years ago. And all this was also found 70 feet underwater. This also proves that whatever was said in Mahabharata proves to be right. But what exactly is the reason of the submerge of the Dwarka city, which exactly no one knows? But actually there are two stories behind it. One story is the scientific story and second is the mythological one. So the story goes like, after a few days of the war, Queen Gandhari went up to the war field and saw 99 of his sons were dead and only Duryodhan who was alive. Post that, she was very furious, very angry, because she's like, Lord Krishna was aware, he could have stopped all of this instead of getting inside into the war and helping the Pandavas. He could have just said something or done something and everything would have come to an end, but he chose not to. Instead, he instigated and initiated the war. And post that, she was so angry that she literally cursed Lord Krishna that, you know, you would lose everything that you have, all your kingdom, all your fame, everything will be destroyed, because this was like a typical mother's curse that was coming through. And she also said that, you know, even if you want things, you will die in a very different way. Your whole of your kingdom will be, you know, vanished in thin air. All of your children will die. Your family will have so many conflicts inside itself that they will kill each other. And all of this actually happened. And Lord Krishna just accepted all of the curse as his fate. And of course, after some time, he lost all his sons because they had a fight in between. He lost all of his kingdom because it was submerged inside water, because that's what the curse was. And the kingdom was completely submerged inside the water, like just out of nowhere. But if we talk scientifically, archaeologists and marine archaeologists and all these people, they stated that there was some kind of sea levels that had risen, and that was the reason of the actual submerge. Though if I have to believe, I would still believe the mythology one. I don't know, what are you going to believe? So this is what exactly happened. And to be very honest, I wouldn't lie. Very recently, I had this desire of going to Dwarka and seeing it, because I recently saw a lot of people going Dwarka and, you know, exploring the city, and that's what I also want to do. I want to see and explore the city. I was completely mesmerized by this story. For a lot of people, it still remains a mystery, like why exactly and what exactly happened with the city of Dwarka. I really want to explore Dwarka soon. I hope I can explore it in the near future. And I hope you guys enjoyed this look. Because I was doing an Indian story and I was like, okay, let's try an Indian look. So what do you think about this look? Please do let me know in the comments below. If you have yet not subscribed, please do hit that subscribe button, because it helps me grow. Also, if you are yet not following me on my Instagram, you can like check somewhere out here. And every Monday I come up with new stories. If this is something that interests you, please do hit the bell icon as well, so you will be notified every single Monday that I come. And till the time I come back, please do take care of yourself, wash your hands, sanitize, wear your mask and go out. And miss me?